As the Palmetto moon rises, seasons are on the line. The month of November has been unkind to the Wolverines, but it's a new team with a new identity. A rematch tonight as Woodruff faces Powdersville, a knockdown drag-out contest 6 weeks ago rekindled at one of the most hallowed venues in the state. Live from WL Varner Stadium, it's Friday night. Powdersville's 10 men all in their sprinter stance. Snow gets the whistle. Approaches the ball. It's playoff time in South Carolina. Demaje Rooks will take it at the 7-yard line on the far hash mark. Trying to get his team up the middle of the field. Splits a couple of defenders up around the 40-yard line. And he's brought down right at the 41. A nice return there from Demaje Rooks. And that is where the Wolverines will take over. Offensively for the Wolverines, across the line, they'll go Robinson, Rhodes, Halloran, Goodman at right guard, Brown at right tackle. Stites, Ramey, Pearson, Rooks are your wide receivers. Corey Moses, the tailback, and Kevon Gist will be the man trying to make it happen. Woodruff ball first and 10 from their own 41. Two receivers both sides. Shotgun to Gist. Looking, trying to get a little cross over the middle. He's got Keith Pearson up around midfield, stiff arm, and he's knocked out of bounds around the 49-yard line. It's an aggressive Powdersville defense. We saw them put a lot of pressure on Kevon Gist in the first meeting. And that time he found Pearson underneath for a gain of 8. They go three receivers to the far side here. Screen pass set up to Demaje Rooks. He's got some blockers over midfield up around the 45-yard line before he is brought down there. So two quick passes to maybe get Kevon Gist in a bit of a rhythm here. That will be enough to move the sticks for the Wolverines. Nice blocking on the perimeter. It'll be a 7-yard gain first down. The motion. Most outside. Now design run from Kevon. He's got a first down. Out comes a flag. Fifth arm. Ball is on the ground, and I think Kevon fell back on top of it around the 20-yard line, but there is a flag on the play. It was thrown back around the 35-yard line. Probably going to be a hold against the Wolverines. We'll see what they call. It is indeed a holding penalty against Woodruff. Defensively for Powdersville, number 63, Tripp Kirkland will start on the defensive line, along with Emery Williams. They'll also have Logan Matter, and number 20, Tyler Robinson, is there as well. It's going to wind up being about a 1-yard penalty against the Wolverines. It'll make it first and 11 from the 45. Two receivers right side. They give it to Most right up the middle. Not a whole lot of running room, but he's able to fall forward for a decent gain there. Corey Most. This is a Wolverine offense that rushed for negative 13 yards last Friday night. They're going to have to find a way to make some hay at the line of scrimmage if they want to get a win here tonight. It's a 3-yard gain for the Wolverines to make it second down and 8 from the 42. They motion the man over to the left side. Gist under a little bit of trouble. Now he's going to have to roll, and he throws it all the way back to Keith Pearson out of his hands. He was coming back to the football around the 32-yard line, and that ball just bounced off of his chest, and he could not corral it. Linebackers for Powdersville, Jim Bob Hayes, Matty Golden, and also number 81, Wheeler Sargent. In the secondary, they'll have Bryce O'Neill, Demarius Cureton, Trent Oglesby, and Josh Dial. Third and 8 for the Wolverines. Gist with a lot of time. Let's throw it out. Got it complete to Whit Ramey around the 33-yard line. He was pushing the pile forward, and I think, Tom, he might have gotten just enough for a first down. We'll see where they spot him. He did indeed get the first down.
Yeah, I think he got it by maybe a half yard.
Not much. Nice job there by the senior wide receiver getting the start tonight. They said they might try to get him some more playing time, and he rewards them with an early first down, the gain of 11. Now Gist will keep it himself. Quarterback draw, nice little pickup there. Bolts his way forward for maybe a gain of 5. Nice pickup there from Kevon, dual threat quarterback. Gain of 7. Now they try to throw the screen back the other way to Demaje, and it was batted down at the line of scrimmage. This is a big Powdersville team in the trenches, and it was Tripp Kirkland who was able to bring that ball to the ground. A nice job there working on the right side of the offensive line. It sets up another third down. I don't think they were quite as big 6 weeks ago. Third down and 4 from the 32-yard line. Woodruff trying to sustain a drive. Gist back to throw. He's got Demaje past the marker up around the 20-yard line. He's brought down, but not before. He picks up enough for the first down. A nice little drive being put together by the Wolverines. Their second conversion on third down. A nice job so far from Kevon Gist. He's spreading the ball around very nicely. That one was a pickup of 11. Now they go screen pass. Left side, Keith Pearson got away from the first wave of defenders. Second wave brought him down. But it's another short gain for the Wolverines. They've sort of nickel and dime their way down the field here. Ball's going to be spotted inside the 20, around the 18-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 3 to bring up a second down. We'll say a gain of 2, so 2nd and 8 coming up.
And, Rick, and this game is starting just like the other one when we played Powdersville. I think we scored on our opening drive to take a 7-0 lead.
Yeah, quarterback keeper up the middle and steps out of the defender. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Wolverine. Kevon Gist, quarterback keeper right up the middle, and he high steps out of a tackle and strides into the end zone. Woodruff strikes first here in the first round. Touchdown run for Kevon Gist, number 7 on the season. And Woodruff with an early 6-0 lead. Kyle Britton will come on to attempt the extra point. Stites will hold. Good snap. The hold is down. Kick is up, and it's through. 8:28 to go in the first quarter. Woodruff on top early. 7-0. You're listening to Wolverine Football. Woodruff up 7-0 early. Rixon Lane and Dom Mobley here with you. 8:28 to go in the first quarter as Kyle Britton kicks this one up high to be taken around the 24-yard line. That was the return, man. Going to bring it back out and around the 29-yard line. He's still running, but he was blown dead. He had a knee on the ground, and Tom, a very efficient opening drive from the Wolverine.
Rixon, that had to feel good, not only for the coaches, but these players after the struggles we had last week against Chesney to get the ball in smarts down the field and get the 7 points out of it. Nice drive.
Patterson will start at the 30-yard line. Their quarterback by Wesley Turner, the senior. He stands 6'3". Woodruff will send Gray, Goodman, and Smoan out on the defensive front. The two Davises and Vincent are the linebackers. Turner in the backfield. They're going to keep it with him on a zone read. Not a whole lot of running room. He's brought down around the line of scrimmage. Goodman and Smoan were there early. The offensive line for Powdersville, Jacob and John Waldrop are the two tackles. The left guard, number 71, Andrew Bishop, the captain. Right guard is Ben Miller. The center for the Patriots is Trevor Cook. Wide receivers for the Patriots, Charquez Daniel, Caleb Nesbitt, Nick Perdomo, and number 82, J.J. Gentile. 4 receivers, 2 split each way for the Patriots. 2nd down and 10 from the 30. Turner, shotgun. They give it to Jacoby Bufford right up the middle. Nowhere to go. The Wolverines were there to make the play. And so Powdersville will be facing a 3rd down and maybe 8 as they swarmed on Bufford, who had a big night last Friday for the Patriots.
And Rick and Clay Gray was one of the 2 or 3 players that were able to stop that play. And he leads this year with 103 tackles, so he's having a super year.
Here's a big 3rd down and 8. Woodruff able to maybe get control of this one early on. See what Powdersville dials up here. They got 3 receivers to the left-hand side, 1 to the right. Fake the handoff. Screen pass in and out of the hands of Jarquez Daniel. A diving interception attempt made by Shadon Jones. But he was unable to come up with it, but the defense stands tall. And the Wolverines will force a punt here early with 6:56 to go in first. So now, with no timeouts remaining, the first string offensive line is coming into the game. And Kevon Gist, who's on the hands team, he's not leaving the field either. They're going to end this right now.
Listen, that was an interesting call on the kickoff, you know, kicking it away like that when instead of the onside kick.
I don't understand it at all, Tom. I really don't. You know, if you kick it away, unless Woodruff has a colossal collapse, this game is over.
Well, you're out of timeouts, and there's less than a minute to go in the ballgame.
Don't understand it at all. After you scratch and claw back from a 28-point deficit late in the fourth quarter, and then really to not even give the team a chance with 50 seconds, and obviously it was a long shot to come back, but they were down 15. And they're still down 15 with 50 seconds remaining, but we'll see what happens here. They're going under center to kneel it. Kevon Gist takes the knee. Play clock's back to 25 as the game clock goes down to 40. Let's see if they're going to have to snap it one more time. I think one more should do it. Clock down to 30.
They haven't started the play clock yet.
No, they haven't. Now they do. They don't have to run another play. They do not have to snap this thing. They're going to anyway. Kevon Gist takes the knee. And you can put this one in the books. 42-27, Woodruff advances to the second round of the 2A Division I state playoffs. A 15-point win over Powdersville. They've beaten the Patriots 2 times this season. And they will take on Newberry here at home next Friday night. Tom, final thoughts as we wrap things up.
But Rixon, we got a pretty substantial lead in the second half, and it, I don't want to say it got away, but Powdersville just kept battling and made it close. But this team, this Woodruff team, still has the prize in sight. Had a great game tonight, a great outing.
42-27, your final score. For Liz, back in the studio, pushing all the buttons, keeping us on the air. For my broadcast partner, Tom Mobley, I'm Rixon Lane. Thanks for joining us. Have a blessed week, everybody. We'll talk to you next Friday night.